Welcome to Zebra Aurora Vision Studio. In this tutorial, we'll learn about different methods of image acquisition, starting from the most basic ones, acquiring images from files and from a web camera. Our software allows you to acquire images from many different sources and supports the vast majority of cameras available in the machine vision market. You can acquire images from files as well as from a web camera, which are the two most basic methods covered in this tutorial. Secondly, it supports all GigiVision and Genicam GenTL compliant devices, which gives you a huge freedom in choosing hardware suitable for your project. Last but not least, you can acquire images from a wide range of third-party cameras using our set of acquisition filters dedicated for selected hardware. We will cover the second and third method in detail in the later parts of this tutorial, but for now, let's focus on acquiring images from files and from a webcam. The very first method of image acquisition is using the LoadImage filter. We can find it in the From Files tool, located in the Image Acquisition section of the toolbox. Let's place this filter in the Acquire section of our program. Next, to load an image, we only need to specify the path to a chosen file. We'll do it in the Properties window, but you can also click the In-File input in the filter block. Let's now drag and drop the out image output into the preview window and run our program. Since there is no filter that generates a loop, our program will iterate only once. As we can see, we've loaded an image and displayed it in the preview window. Another method of loading images from files is using the EnumerateImages filter. Compared to the LoadImage, which loads only a single file, EnumerateImages allows us to load a whole folder from the hard drive and go through all images inside, one image for every single iteration of the program. Let's get the EnumerateImages filter from the From Files tool. This time, we need to provide a path to the folder containing images we want to use. As this is a more advanced filter, there are also more properties we can adjust. For now, let's just set the inRepeat to true to make our program run in a loop, and set inDelay to 1000 to have a new image appear every 1 second. Let's change the preview layout by splitting the preview window and drag and drop the outImage output of the EnumerateImages filter into it. When done, we can now run our program. As expected, in each iteration, there is a new image loaded from our test folder. Let's check another, simpler way of loading images from files, but first, let's remove all the filters from our program and reset the previews. We can simply drag and drop a file or a folder directly into the program editor. This will also automatically add a required filter to our program. Here, we just loaded a single file, but the same can be done with folders. The last method we are going to look at is acquiring images directly from a camera. To start with, we'll use a web camera, as such devices are accessible to everyone. Let's add the web camera tool into our program. If you have multiple web cameras connected to your computer, you can choose which one to use in the properties window, as well as set some basic parameters. Now, let's try to display the image stream coming from the web camera. And there we go! Believe me or not, it's as simple as that. This concludes our tutorial. If you want to learn more, please take a look at our technical documentation available at Zebra Aurora Vision Developer Portal. You can find links to the sections of the documentation relevant to this tutorial in the video description below. Thank you for watching. For more information on Zebra Aurora Vision software products, visit us at aurora-vision.zebra.com.